right here. It's inside here. He's not with a bat case.
Thank you. How are you?
Mike?
Hi.
To go? Yeah, I want to be able to fit it into my basket on my bike. I have a little, like a
carbon. I don't want to put your fries home because, you know, I want to give you the fries. The fries ready, so we're going to put...
Cool, thank you. Chocolate. We got some big boys coming with jalapenos, cheeseburgers.
Burgermeister. What's going on, brother?
What's up with you, brother?
I'm riding and hiding today, trying to get back to the office to do paperwork. I live on paperwork. Like, my guys, we do the jobs, and the next thing you know, I gotta sit on paperwork for so many hours.
I hate paperwork. I would fail.
I'm behind right now, probably.
What do you do?
A couple of months. Plumbing and construction. I have a company right here for the last, since early 90s. So, you know, it's like.
I'm changing my grease truck.
Let me tell you, the new codes that are out. They are, they double, triple everything. So, you know, when it comes to the traps and stuff like that, I gotta fight the traffic right now to get back into my insurance. But no.
You're a motorcycle,
huh?
You're a motorcycle.
Yeah, but I have to drive up the shoulder. Should I get something to drink?
Water.
Bring water.
Can I have a little cup of water?
No. I'll drink it at home. I have it. I actually make my own water at home.
Yeah, I have a filter too. I don't trust in that tap water
pollution. I make it for 30 years. I make my own water.
I don't trust in that tap water pollution.
A lot of shit in the water.
Yeah, they drink it like it's fucking.
There's more chemicals than a pool. All you gotta do is test it. Go buy a test kit. See, fluoride. Why would you put a pharmaceutical byproduct in our potable water? Not too big, too big. I'm on a motorcycle. I need as small as possible.
You have plastic bag?
Yeah.
Yeah, not even plastic. I'll just take it like this. Hopefully,
no,
I can fit this.
Take the plastic so it's tied together.
Yeah, hopefully, I can. I mean, I gotta put it in my pouch. I have a little carbon pouch.
Yeah, that's the plastic bag. You're just gonna hold it.
Same size. Yeah. But no, I mean, if you ever need me over here, I have to talk to Manny D. Super plumber.
Super plumbing?
Plumber. Super plumber. Been in the beach for a while.
Oh, yeah. What's her name? My manager, she just sent me you up there.
Yeah. Mike. My name's Mike. Not on the car. That's but if you I can give you my cell if you want, just in case you have any issues or whatever. That's my office number. It's the actual same number on the car. The last number is 775. Nobody's on there. Am I? Injuries. feel like everything is different. You know, I don't know if you know what it is to be like really out of shape. It's like, and then from being in shape.
Now I struggle because I fucked up my knee, I fell, and then a week ago I fell on my back down the stairs. So I fucked all that up.
If you're getting those kind of injuries, I got whipped out my infested wall, took an organ out of here. My C5 is crushed from a car crash. Three discs on my lower, I recovered. But if you have all those issues, I do alchemy and holistic as well. So if you need certain advice to heal them naturally, don't let the doctors push you.
No, I don't go to fucking
so
I hate doctors.
If you have back problems, buy an inversion table. I live on one.
Inversion table?
Inversion table. I live on one.
Uh-huh.
Upside down.
Okay.
Amazing. If you have knee problems, you need to regenerate the fluid. How you do that is, we'll get a 3-pound weight, strap it to your leg, let your foot hang, right? And just gently let it move. 3 or 4 times on each side. Do this 3 or 4 times a day. With the weight, let it hang. What this does is it circulates fresh fluid through the knees and it repairs them naturally. So, people don't know this. The body heals itself. You just have to give it that little extra push. In other words, like an inversion table, I've been on one since my car crashed at 19. I really hurt my back bad. They paid me over $1 million for it, and it all went to medicine. But if you ever need anything, text me and we'll go from there.
Thank you for your support, brother.
See you soon.
Okay?
Anytime. All right, time to get back on the road. And going to do paperwork, which, I really hate doing. This light's gonna take forever, man.
back on. Motherfuckers, bro. Fucking garbage ass people, man. No warnings, no nothing. They just cut off the damn highway like that, bro. Now, you can't even go 95 north from 395. They push you on to 836, where you're going to have to get off the highway and travel down to the north. Ridiculous, man. Horrible. I don't know what the hell this town is coming to, but the city does whatever the hell they want. And then I got to sit at these stupid-ass lights. Okay, we'll see how many lights I'm gonna sit at. Okay, I got a little amusement while I'm waiting at this light. There we go. You're doing it. In the middle of the street. Look me up on IG. That's pretty good. Twin Dragon Mike. IG, Twin Dragon Mike. IG, Twin Dragon Mike.
What is?
Twin, my IG.
Ah.
Oh. Twin Dragon Mike.
Okay, say hi from Argentina, from Colombo Show 24.
All right.
See you. Thank you.
Well, I'm stuck at these bullshit ass lights, which I really want to run every single one of them, but at least I get a little amusement. Here's another one here. The city really does anything that they please. So does the state. The state and city does whatever they want, and we don't do nothing about it. This right now I'm going through is because I can't get on to 95 North. her and wait for this light. Because of 95 being closed off to me, I literally have to take another 20 minutes, maybe even more, just to get home. It's looking hot as hell out here too. Chopper right there too. I gotta split all these lanes. Hopefully it keeps on going.